Until we see more Americans vaccinated, do you believe there are going to have to be restrictions reimposed? For example, the World Health Organization is saying people should now again be wearing masks indoors because of this variant.
Yeah, we have to be careful to distinguish what the World Health Organization has to deal with. The World Health Organization has to deal with recommendations for the entire planet, which is an undervaccinated planet. About 10% of the people are vaccinated in the world. Some countries, even less than that. So there are some countries where the virus is raging with a high dynamics of spread. So even if you are vaccinated and you're in that environment, the chances with a vaccine that, as good as it is, no vaccine is 100%. And we know that even the good vaccines, the ones that we really do know protect about 88% against infection that's symptomatic and over 90% against severe infection. There are vaccines that are being used globally that are not nearly as good as that. And then there are those who've only received one dose because of a shortage right. of vaccinations. And we know that in certain situations, one dose, the efficacy goes down from like 88% down to around 30%. So it's no wonder that the WHO was saying that even if you are vaccinated and you're in an area with a high density of virus, that you, in fact, should still wear a mask indoors. In the United States, it's a bit different. We want to make clear that there will be some people, understandably, and there's nothing wrong with that, who are vaccinated, who don't want to take any risk. They're very risk averse. I think particularly elderly people and people who have underlying conditions, they may consult with their physician or a healthcare provider and say, you know, I really don't want to take any risk at all. It's perfectly fine for those people to wear a mask. But as a country, the CDC at this point has not changed the recommendation that if you are vaccinated, you do not need to wear a mask. They are following the dynamics of this outbreak literally on a daily basis. And if the data change to indicate there should be a change in a guideline, that change would be made. But right now, things will stay the same vis-a-vis the original guidelines from the CDC.
So I hear you saying the door is open, possibly, to reinstating some restrictions, depending on where this variant goes.